Hi, I'm SJ McCardle. Welcome to Droichead Arts Centre's Solo at Home. We have an action-packed episode for you this week, folks. We have music from Róisín Ward Morrow, we have music from Thomas Walsh of Pugwash, and we have more music from the great Niamh Regan. To kick us off today, we have Dagogo Hart. Dagogo is a writer based in Dublin. He started off in rap, actually, before moving to poetry and then eventually to performance poetry. He formed a great collective, a poetry collective in 2018 called We Are Griot with Felly Speaks. He writes about his hometown of Lagos, but also about his experiences since moving to Ireland. A fascinating poet. He's accompanied here by the Kildare-based producer and pianist, Adam Garrett. So we were very interested to ask Dagogo and Adam about the subject of home.
So my name is Dagogo Hart.
I'm Adam Garrett.
And this is Adam's home.
This is my home, so this is essentially visually what home means to me.
I suppose to me home is mainly transient. Physically, obviously, because I move a lot.
Yeah.
Move from Nigeria, even in Ireland, I move from Tralee to Cork, from Cork to Dublin. But the most important thing for me is the people. The people make home.
Yeah.
Like right now for me, home is where I live with my fiance.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the people make home for me. How about yourself?
It's heavily community based, I think. Yeah. Home is like somewhere where people pass through, you know, as much as you do yourself.
Yeah.
You know, and there's just good energy and wholesome vibes, and not necessarily related family, but family you kind of grow with.
Exactly.
Yeah. I guess that's what it is to me.
Yeah. And he obviously influences our work.
Yeah.
Ends up most of the stuff I write about.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. You can just come here and then we can just do a gig.
Exactly.
You know,
yeah.
That's in like home.
A home.
Yeah.
Yeah. I used to think you knew your soulmate if your chin fit perfectly in the nook of your neck. My first girlfriend was pretty awesome at giving hugs. But I knew the kind of woman I wanted to marry the day I watched my mother hum her favorite song while doing the dishes. I knew the kind of man I wanted to be the day I watched my father slow dance with my mother to her humming. Would my son ever watch me slow dance with his mother? Or would I always be writing poems about leopard print skins and French fries here? I carry all these things on top of my heart, and I fear if it gets broken, it'll all fall through the cracks. Maybe I have a flawed perception of romance. Maybe slow dancing, humming dishwashers don't exist. Maybe gorgeous earthquakes aren't always heartbreaking or groundbreaking. I feel like each second is a grain of sand, and the waves are washing away my sandcastles one after the other. People always tell me I make the truth the hardest to understand, so I guess what I'm trying to say is I feel like time is running out. And with all the so-called fish in the ocean, these waves never seem to leave any of my shores. Maybe I'm too blind, concentrating on fish when there's great blue whales around, tiger sharks, and even electric eels that would always have a spark. I've been living too fast, but there's no point finishing first if there's no one waiting at the finish line. I'd rather slow dance for humming, or maybe in essence we would be the ones that won. I knew the kind of man I wanted to be the day I watched my father slow dance with my mother to no music in the living room. I know she eagerly anticipates the day her and I slow dance to my wedding song. I hope this is not another failed attempt of me trying to get closer to that day.
For the next song, I'd love to share with you this first single from my album called Save the Day. And it'll be a nice acoustic version compared to the studio version with the full band, so we'll see how it goes. What's the matter with the time I keep it drawing circles around me all day? Why can't I complete a task and feel good at the end of the day? Why don't you turn the TV off and go on and feel that sun on your face? I can't explain the lump in my chest, it holds me down, pushes you away. I told you I was doing just fine this way. There's no need to worry that way. I'm doing it for you, I'm doing it for the kids' sake. I wish I could save the day. What's the matter with mercy? It doesn't crawl around you no more. No quick fix is knocking at your door. No quick fix coming soon. And I told you every day what they told me today. Even if that means I can't feel my face, I'm doing it for you, I'm doing it for.
This next song was a single about 20 years ago. Oh, I'm getting old. And wise. Getting old and wide. That's what I'm doing. But this was a song that, you know, I'm such a big Beatles fan and things like that. You know, obviously they used to release singles that weren't on the albums. So if you look back to the Beatles career, you see a lot of records. Of course, very famous records that we know and love that were never on albums. We Can Work It Out, Day Tripper, you know, Paperback Writer, all those incredible things, Strawberry Fields. It just goes on and on. Lady Madonna goes on and on. And so I decided, I wrote the song kind of separate to the second album sessions that we were doing at the time. And I said, let's just do a one-off single. I spoke to Michael O'Shea at my old label, the old Velo Records, great little label, and they said, yeah, that's a good idea. And I said, I have a silly song called Apples, and they went, that sounds good, that sounds healthy. And I said, okay. And we did a separate session. It turned out to be quite ridiculous, as we did loads of different versions, but so the Trills were a big fan of this single when it was out at the time, and they were having a lot of success. But, you know, a lot of people loved it. George Bourne, you know, there was a lot of stalwarts and people in the business that were really shouting for me. But, you know, we were such a small, the label was so small, and the money was so tight and stuff, you know, we just couldn't really. But anyway, it's still there if you want to hear it. It's all over the net, and, you know, it's still around. But this is a live version. It's called Apples.
Thomas Walsh of Pugwash. We've got time for just one more artist this week, folks, before we say goodbye. Thank you to all of our artists for taking part, and thank you for tuning in. We'll see you next week for another episode of Solo at Home. But to play us out, very appropriately, here is Róisín Ward Morrow and the gorgeous Slán Ó Bhaile.
I'm going to play an air now called Slán Ó Bhaile. This is a tune that I wrote a few years ago. And actually, I'm accompanied here by my harmonium. It's here on the ground. This is an instrument that originates from the northern part of India. There's a pump on one side and there are keys on the other side. So my hands are a bit busy playing the fiddle to play with the keys, but I'm able to keep a drone going with my leg as I play. So that's what you'll be hearing now in a wee minute. Originally, this piece actually has a great piano arrangement accompanying it, which was written by my great friend, and he's an excellent musician, Brefni Houlihan. He actually featured in the last series of Solo at Home, so you should definitely check him out. And if you like what you hear after this, you should go check out the full arrangement of Slán Ovalia on my album By the Light of the Moon. So I'm going to give it a go here now, without Brefni, just all on my own with the harmonium. I hope you enjoy.